Jamie was a good student, friend of the family. He babysit their dogs when they went on vacation. And so when the time came to preach, the pastor said, "Sure, I'll do it." Well, when he got to the sermon, he turned to Jamie and he asked a question. He said, "Before I start, you have to make a choice. I've written three sermons, and with each sermon comes a gift for you, because you're graduating. You have to choose which gift you want, and then with the gift comes the sermon." Okay. Well, the first gift was this beautiful bowl that the pastor grabbed. And it had water in it. It didn't say the sign. It was very pretty, actually. Stoneware. It had this ruffled edge across the top. It was painted all these different colors. It was nice. The second gift was money. Straight out, it was a gift card for $100. Visa card, good anywhere. Or a MasterCard. And the last one, believe it or not, was one of these. A great big spike. Which do you want? Which would you want as your gift? You can only have one. See, sitting where we are, when we are, we probably have an idea that the gift card's not the best choice, right? Probably not. So we have the bowl of water and the spike. Jamie chose the water, which of course led into baptism and being reborn and renewed and cleansed from sin. He quickly put away the money. But afterwards, a few of us went over and asked, "What was the other sermon? What was the spike?" And the teacher said, "The spike is no sermon. The nail is simply looking to the cross and saying, your job is to do that. And you can't." When Jesus went to the garden and took his disciples with him, they went to pray. They had followed him, carrying their crosses, to try and do what he was doing, to try and be part of this new change. They had been washed, they had been led, but they couldn't do that. I mean, if they could, that crowd with the clubs and the swords wouldn't necessarily be looking for just Jesus, right? Whom do you seek? Well, we seek the one who changes things. We seek the one who's important. We seek the one who can do what we can't. So as we gather together this Good Friday, I ask you, whom do you seek? What do you choose? Do you seek someone who just forgives, who washes us and lets us go back out? Do you seek power here? Do you seek a moment's rest, a little bit of peace and comfort? Or do we seek a life of service? one whose joy comes as a gift after the service is done. One whose outward signs bring on gains. But one that know your work can do. One that lives on for all eternity. Whom do you choose? What do you want for your life? Amen.